All right. Back to the experience. We've got our next guest up, Ryan with PSA. Ryan, how's it going, man?
Awesome. Thanks for having me on.
Yeah, again, no problem. So just went over to your guys' booth. Well, like I said, we're doing a software day, trying to anyway, so we're grabbing everybody. I know your names come up a lot, but I don't know. I'm not a software guy, so I don't know what you guys are doing, but I'm happy to have you here to explain to everybody else why, like I said, your names come up a lot, so perfect. What you guys are doing. But yeah, I'll let you go ahead, do a little background information on you, who you are, and then we can talk about PSA.
Sure. So, you know, the company started back in 1994. We're a Canadian-based company, and PSA actually stands for Proven Solutions Accounting.
Okay.
We shortened it because it was easier to say PSA. And we came into this industry probably around 2002 as an accounting solution, looking to find like a niche market that we could help with job costing and workflow. And at the time, the only other software that was in this space was JPP. And they did job management. And they were the first job management system to link to Xactimate, who did all the estimating and pricing for the industry.
Okay.
So we kind of formed like this triangle of where we did the accounting piece, JPP did the job management, and Xactimate did the estimating.
Okay.
So we kind of created this ecosystem that allowed contractors to share their financial information, work orders with the job management side, and then tie that into the estimating side so they could get information to flow from call comes in to collections.
Okay. So all the billing money side of it, that's where you guys are focused.
That's where we started. And then what happened is, you know, in the early 2000s, JPP fell out of the relationship with Xactimate, and we kind of filled the gap with job management. So we took on the accounting and the job management at that point. So we kind of married the two worlds together, both the production side and the financial side.
Okay.
So it gave contractors this real-time visibility to say, what am I spending every day? Versus what are we bringing in the door and how are we budgeting that so we can manage not only pushing this work through, but are we becoming a profitable business that can scale and grow?
Interesting. Okay. So I guess with PSA, I'm going to go real basic.
Yep.
When do I, is it an app? Is it online? You log in?
So we started off in the early, you know, 90s being a desktop server-based system.
Okay.
Since then, we've migrated all of our applications to web-based and mobile-based applications so a business can run in the cloud while having their guys out in the field on their phones communicating with them in real time.
Okay. And so that's my next question. So when we open up the app, why are we opening it? From start to finish.
So we've kind of rebranded ourselves as an ERP solution, which in essence is like from call comes in to that collection side, we handle everything in between.
Okay.
Right? So the minute you open that app, it's because a new lead has come in, a new job has come in, we're recording that customer information, we're dispatching it to the guy out in the field who's taking photos, who's signing documents, who's putting in their communications with the customer.
Now, are those things like fill in the blanks that are in the app, those documents and those things exist?
Yeah, so the way our system works is we kind of configure to the business that we're working with. So like when we're working with a new company, we get them to build their own forms in the system. We get them to populate those drop-downs. So it's not, you know, here's a model that you have to fit into.
Gotcha.
It's we want to form around your company so that it works with your process and your behaviors that you already have instilled.
Okay, I understand. Okay, so we got the tech, he's in the field, he's taking some pictures, where do we go from here?
So, I mean, once all the criteria of what I need to capture in the field, that initial scope information, the communications, the dates, the images, videos, and documents, that file is now relayed back to the office, and it allows us, depending on the type of work, to now communicate with things like Exact Analysis, Xactimate, till we get to that scoping stage where we can actually start to bring our budgets and our estimates into the system. Whereas, again, that's where we shine. That's where we set ourselves apart from a lot of the other technologies out there, is that we put a lot of emphasis in recording those job costs in real time. For example, there are companies out there that handle just time cards, being able to record labor for your employees on a daily basis. That's built into our system. So that same guy who's taking photos, he's also recording his time out in the field. And when that time comes back to us, that same day I know what my labor is, even before I process payroll.
I see. Okay. So that's really cool.
Mm-hmm.
I really like that. And now, and then I'm sure everyone has, once this file's been created, then everyone has access to it. Or
full transparency.
Yeah.
I mean, obviously there's security in there because when you're dealing with financials, you don't want everyone in your company to see what your margins are.
Who should see it gets to see it.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So there are key people that on the production side, they live and die by those numbers as far as like, is this job profitable? What's our budget? Are we on spending? What commitments have we made to subtrades that we expect to come in this month that we have to pay out right? So we're running our business by the numbers, not just by the cycle times.
Okay, very cool. What's next?
So obviously once all this information's in, we got our scope, we're starting to record job costing. You click a button, we now can send that payable entry into our financial system and pay those bills to those vendors. I don't need to rekey anything in. It just flows from production to accounting seamlessly.
Oh, interesting.
I need to send out an invoice. I need to pay a bill. Everything translates from that production side into the accounting side. So there are now checks and balances where we're following everything through. There's no gaps, or I get that plumber invoice a month from now and I think to myself, well, what job was this on? Is it closed or is it still open? I have that visibility throughout the entire production process.
That's really cool. Mm-hmm. Okay. I like that a lot. Now we've got the information, like jobs completed, right?
Yep.
Now what?
So in the system, obviously the accounting side handles like the collections processing, being able to follow up and make sure our receivables and our aging comes down so that we're not sitting on a bunch of closed jobs that we haven't collected on yet. So there's that aspect. But there's also an aspect in the system that I find a lot of contractors don't really pay attention to, and that's the CRM aspect that we've built in as well, where, you know, a lot of times we're waiting for these jobs to come in as part of that funnel pipeline. But who's out there marketing, filling that pipeline, building those relationships, making sure that those leads are coming in consistently? And so that, to me, is where the CRM piece ties in for our sales and marketing team that are going out and having those relationships with the agents and adjusters that are actually allowing us to get organic leads in outside of that TPA market, which is being fed to us right now.
Okay.
Right? So it's allowing our business to stay healthy because we want those leads to keep coming in and those job opportunities to come in so we can grow and scale our business instead of waiting for a catastrophic event to happen.
Sure. So when you're talking about you're going, it's keeping the sale, or like bringing in the new leads, are those are getting entered into the software somehow, or like how?
So, I mean, for now, like because all these pieces are connected, any lead we have on the accounting side, any invoice we sent out or any bill we pay out, that now syncs to our relationship list. On the production side, anyone we're working with, those vendors, those agents, those adjusters, they're part of our database of relationships.
I see, okay.
And so the CRM side, what it's bringing in is, who are we not looking at right now that potentially could be bringing us new opportunities?
So what you're saying, so not only are you keeping track of who's doing work with you, you're
yep.
also now able to look at who's not doing work with you and build on those relationships.
And one of the statistics I find is so important, especially on the sales and marketing side, we have customers that will come to us and say, I know where my business is coming from, but I don't know where I can grow from here. Like, where do I turn to get new opportunities?
Right.
And one of the easiest things you can ask a system like ours is, show me people that I've worked with that have never referred a job to us before. Those agents, those adjusters, those property
yeah.
managers that we've worked with them before, but that job didn't come from them. So we can have our sales and marketing team go after those people and start to build the relationship so when something happens, the first person they call is that preferred vendor.
Right. And those relationations have already been started. They just haven't been cultivated.
And a lot of times, I mean, just because this industry is naturally reactive,
right.
a lot of times those salespeople are just dealing with the people that are front and center, the people that they have good relationships with. But there's a whole market in there of people that we maybe don't hear from in a while. And unless our focus is driven towards them, we may lose sight of them or they may fall off our radar.
Sure. I mean, if you're not working on it daily, weekly,
yep.
how are you going to remember 3 months ago this job? So that's really cool. You're able to track that.
And our CRM is really driven around what are the pains that the sales and marketing people in this industry have. And it's a lot of it's about how do we lose focus on those markets that we're not touching on or they're not seeing. And so the system will actually remind those marketers, here's a list of people that you haven't spoken to in 60 days. I don't have to find them in the system. It knows
it
just based
you.
On our delay of our actions with
yeah.
them. Right? It's been 60 days since
cool.
that last job came in, or 60 days since my last face-to-face with that agent. Now they're back in focus. Now they're on my radar because they're telling me, here
it's
are the
right
people
here.
You
it's
haven't
in my
spoken
face again.
To.
Yeah.
And right? And this is all connected.
I love that.
And again, like today, I find contractors struggle with this idea that everything's piecemeal. Like my business runs off 12 pieces of software.
That's what we were just talking about.
And none
yeah.
of them talk together. And so it's a very disconnected process. You know, my sales team doesn't know what my production team's doing. My finance team doesn't know what my CRM team is doing because they're all living in these separate islands.
Right.
Right? That don't talk together. And so when you start to connect these dots together, what you get in a business is something where we're not reacting to information. We're being proactive with what's going on around us.
Right.
Right. And the system's telling us, hey, you need to look at this or focus on that. And it may exist in all of these different divisions in our business.
Well, and that's where this word integration has been coming up a lot, and a lot of, and I've seen it where a lot of companies are working together.
Yep.
I know I was just talking with like Chuck DeWald and Tom McGuire, and how they have their apps and they're doing different things on different jobs, but how then they're working with software. Are you working with anybody else, or how are you connecting those dots between a company using 7-10 different apps?
Yep. So, I mean, I like to think of it as like the insurance ecosystem, right? In this industry, there are staples that have to be used as a contractor, like the Xactimates or the Symbilities that, or the Micas that are a requirement of doing that type of work, right? If we're doing insurance work, we have to use those. And so our philosophy early on was we can't be the jack of all trades, but
right. We
have an open API that allows us to talk bi-directionally with a lot of these vendors. So a lot of these systems that you see on the show floor, like the Clean Claims, the Encircles, the Xactimates, we have open integration with them that allows us to share those critical points of data that are a requirement in the industry to now pass freely through that ecosystem. Right? So we're not forcing the contractor to say, hey, you have to use this system to get time cards. We're saying, find the solution that's going to fit your business and let the data now come together and talk.
And then we'll talk. Okay. So you guys are already, I mean, you're already built and working with other probably.
We have about 90 integrations, but
okay.
they span, like, for instance, on the accounting side, we integrate with like ADP and Paychex because they're staples for like payroll.
Right.
You know, on the production side, we integrate with systems like DocuSketch and Clean Claim and Encircle because those are staples for the production side. And then on the CRM side, we link to staples like Twilio for text messaging and MailChimp for bulk mailing.
What's Twilio? I've never heard of Twilio.
Twilio is a text messaging service that's set up that allows your mobile device to take the text messages and communicate them back into a system. So if I'm texting the customer,
okay, gotcha,
and I want that text message from my personal phone to come back into the job management system, their API allows me to take that raw data and now feed it into, you know, our platform.
So all our
communications are now kind of tied into one basket.
Got it.
And we're not going to recreate Twilio. I mean, they're a huge staple in all industries that use text messaging services. So rather than recreate that wheel, it just makes sense to integrate to a partner like that.
Absolutely.
That says they're the expert in that field, and we're going to leverage that expertise to make it easier for the end user to get that information.
No, I like that. And that's smart. I think that's smart business to like do what you do best.
Sure.
And let other people do what they do best. And you're working together. So as far as the PSA though, you're really focused on the money and the accounting side is where you guys are shining.
Right now, I mean, our three pillars are accounting, CRM, and production. So those are the three main areas that we've kind of developed as our core solution. And then all of these other pieces that we talked about, they're an important part of that ecosystem to, you know, make sure that information flows freely into our system and that nothing gets missed or is left out.
Well, very cool. Well, we'll go ahead and wrap this up. I really appreciate the time coming over here talking
awesome.
With me. Is there anything like final thought? Anything you want to make sure people know? Any contact information?
Sure. I mean, if anyone needs to get a hold of us, certainly they can call us toll free at 877-712-2626 in the sales lines extension 3. We have our sales email, which is just sales@canamsys.com. And if you're at the experience, obviously stop by our booth and take a look at our live demo.
Very cool. Now, last question. We've just started day two. How's the show been for you so far?
It's been really good. I mean, it was a steady, you know, pace for the people at the show. We've seen customers. We've seen new opportunities come through. It's a good collection, I think, of both, you know, restoration contractors and cleaning contractors that we see at this show.
Very cool. Well, again, Van, Ryan, thank
awesome.
You for taking the time. I really appreciate it, man. Have a good show.
Thank you.